Welcome to episode 4 of King's Quest 5. So last week, we dealt with a wicked witch, and she was in her little woods, and we got rid of her. We got, for our trouble, some shoes, and we got a heart. Now, I have maybe sorted out the text issues, but I'm not sure, because it belatedly occurred to me that King's Quest 5 was made for 286s, so what I've done is I've dialed my game down a little, so hopefully it won't be as fast, but we'll see. He decides not to bother her further. Right, so we picked up the heart for her. Let's give that to her. My heart, you found it. I don't need this old thing anymore. Look at me! I'm a princess again! Herbert! Alicia! That was the mopey guy we saw earlier. And they were happy. Where have you been all this time, my love? Oh, darling, just take me home. I'll tell you on the way. I love that. That sound effect of the harp hitting the floor. Oh god. Anyway, we need the harp, so let's go grab that. Bending down, Graham picks the harp up off the ground and takes it with him. One other very quick thing. We're gonna go this way and discover. Dun dun dun. The gypsy camp has gone. But they've left a tambourine for us, so we're gonna grab that. Not seeing the tambourine's owner, Graham bends down and rescues it from the ground. So, very quickly, because we haven't done this yet, so let's go look at our harp. It is a small harp of beautifully carved mahogany. And we did not look at the tambourine. It is an ordinary tambourine. I mean, that's very descriptive. Thanks, Sierra. I like how they do that. Okay, so we are going to move along. The descriptions are so descriptive. Okay, let's head this way. This is the part of the game, basically, where you're giving things to people to get other things. So this guy, it's not obvious. Excuse me, sir. What are you doing here? Yeah, we talked about this. We've actually had... we've actually had this conversation. Graham attempts to speak to the young gnome, but the boy seems very shy and doesn't answer. This is not super obvious. I'm not sure how you would ever work this out in 100 million years. But if you give him the... in fairy tales, there are stories of people who can take a spinning wheel and turn straw into gold. So that would be a high enough price. Where did you get this? I thought I'd lost it. Oh, it is yours? I found it in an old witch's house in the dark forest. So that's where it got to. The old hag took it, eh? You know, this ain't no ordinary spinning wheel. Yes, tell us. It's not? What's so special about it? Why, this spinning wheel can spin straw into gold. That's what. Except, you gotta know how to use it. I don't even know what you could figure that out. Thank you for bringing it back to me. Wait, not so fast. How about that marionette? Don't you think the price of the spinning wheel is worth at least twice that of the puppet? I'd love to have it. Yeah, I guess so, boy. Give that marionette to the man here. I'll make you a new one. Come on, boy. Let's go gather some wood for a new puppet. And off they go. Okay, so you get the marionette from the guy. The craftsmanship of the marionette is superb. I wish they'd tell you more, but they don't. So, okay. The thing now, right, is that I think we need to go east. Yeah, we do. Oh, no, no. Actually, we don't. We need to go south. Because there's lots of little errands we need to do on the way. And I've got, like, a little checklist. And I'm busy working off the list. So there's this little haystack here, which we haven't actually ever searched through. A large haystack dominates the area in front of the barn. And now we're going to search through it. Graham watches with surprise. The contingent of ants marches into the haystack and begins to swarm through it. You know, an old chestnut of a needle in a haystack? Well, here we go. I'm glad to see there was a way that we could be of help to you. Look here, we found a gold needle in a haystack. I'd like to present it to you. Perhaps you can find a use for it. Thank you, Mr. Sir Anthony, or King Anthony. That's kind. Why, thank you, King Anthony. I'm honored. Good luck in your travels, King Graham, and be careful. Okay, so let's check out our gold needle. This is a large gold needle. Ah, so descriptive. Okay. And now we're going to save because I'm invariably going to screw this up. Welcome to episode 4, in case you weren't aware this was episode 4. Okay, so here's a bit of the game that you only have one shot at. And if you screw this up, it's an unwinnable situation. You can't actually win the game. So I am hopefully not going to screw it up. But we'll see. I might. What you need to do is you need to get to the right-hand side of the screen, just about here. I'm going to save again before I trigger the event. So that if I do screw it up, we have not got a problem. I'm going to take the old shoe into our possession and save again. Oh god, so terrifying. I hate these unwinnable situations that Sierra sometimes dreams up. And this is one of them. So, what's going to happen once I get there? Frantic squeakings alert Graham to a mangy cat chasing a terrified rat. And now, what you need to do is, you need to be very quick there. Too late, the poor rat is already in the clutches of the wily cat. And that's an unwinnable situation. If the cat catches the rat, then you are screwed. So, we got to be faster. Okay, I don't think, yeah, I do. Okay, good. Right. Success. Oh, thank you, good sir. You saved my life. My children and I will never forget your kindness. Maybe someday I'll be able to return the favor. Oh, I hear my children calling. Goodbye, until we meet again. I'm so glad they didn't give him a name, because can you imagine? It would be something like Mousini or something. Okay, so, we need to go this way to the town. And in the town, there's like a handful of things that we need to do as well. But the whole thing here is that we're getting ready to go on a big journey. Because we've got to go and find Mordak's castle. And that's basically the whole thing here. Let's go inside of there. Oops, I hit the wrong place, but it's okay. I keep forgetting that Graham doesn't listen to you. Come in, look around. Let me know if you're interested in anything. Okay, so we are going to give this guy the marionette, because he really likes that whole sort of thing. The shipment of carving wood hasn't come in yet. What should we do? If it's not in by tomorrow, I'll send you to visit the sawmill. Okay, Papa. Grandpapa? Oh, can I get, you really like the doll. We've had this conversation before. I was gonna give you that. Where did you get this wonderful baronet? The craftsmanship is excellent. Well, I don't know if you'll believe me or not, but I got it from a little gnome. I must have it. Can I buy it from you? Actually, you may trade it if you'll give me the sled in trade. Why, of course, but I must tell you, I think I'm getting the better deal. I can always make another sled, but finding another marionette of this quality? I don't know. So can I have the sled? Why, yes, yes, take it, it's yours. Hooray, okay, thank you very much. I think I'll find the sled very useful, you will indeed. Well, you enjoy it, and thank you for the marionette. Graham will find a useful sled, believe you me. This is a small, well-crafted sled. Okay, and out we go. I meant to really go into here. And that customer's still there. May I help you, sir? Right, and we're going to give him the needle. Because he will like that. My gold needle! Wherever did you find it? It was found in the haystack by the inn. By the inn? Oh yes, I remember visiting there not long ago. Vulgar man, that innkeeper. He has no scruples at all. Well, I'm glad to see you've got your gold needle back. I wonder, could you possibly see fit to give me that wonderful cloak in exchange for it? The cloak? Well, why not? It's yours for the price of the gold needle. Okay, well, thank you, kind sir. I'm sure it'll help me on my travels. I'm sure it will. Good luck. Au revoir. Okay. And then, the other thing we need to do... Basically, you need to give all of these people things that they're expecting. Because this is... It's all just one big glorified fetch quest at this point. So, take a look around if you... okay, they don't have any shoes. Yes, we've had that conversation. Okay, so... they will want the fine shoes. Little gnome-made ones. I don't know if we ever... Well, we didn't, I don't think, because... This is the finest pair of shoes Graham has ever seen, although a bit small for his feet. Yeah, I'll say. I can't remember having looked at those before, so... What'll be here? Mama, take these shoes from the young man. Let me see them. Man, can't you get them yourself? Okay. These are the finest pair of shoes I've ever seen. The leather is soft and pliable, yet sturdy. The craftsmanship of the shoes is superb. And Mama, look at the solid gold buckle. Well, I could retire with a sale of these shoes. Then the shoes are yours. I don't think I could find any use for them. You're a godsend, young man. How can we ever repay you? You don't need to repay me. Just knowing I helped you is enough for me. He's so selfless. Wow. Well, it ain't much, but it's all I got to give you. Here, take my cobbler's hammer. Perhaps you can find a use for it. Since I'll be retiring, I won't need it anymore, thanks to you. Why, thank you. A hammer will come in mighty useful on my journey. Take care, young man. We'll never forget this. That's right, son. We'll finally be able to retire in comfort. You'll be in our hearts from now on. What? Come on, Mama. Let's go home. Let's celebrate our good fortune. Did he just call you son? That was awkward. Okay. we got a hammer. A cobbler would normally use a small hammer to make shoes. Okay, and suddenly now, because there's no one here, it's very fast. Righty-ho. Now, we have to do a thing that, like I said, would have got us into an unwinnable situation. So, an episode or two ago, I think it was, I'm not sure, we went into here, well, not into here, but, because this is the place where we got the custard pie. We went into here. This is the inn, as far as I remember. Let's just save before we do anything dumb. So Sorry, I keep meaning not to use that word before I say do anything silly. That is not a good word to be using. I'll wait for you out here. I don't like that place. It is the inn. Okay, so if we look, we'll see. Huddled over the bar, Graham notices three rough-looking men deep in a serious conversation. Since they're talking in such low tones, Graham can't quite hear what they're saying. So he gets involved. Gentlemen, please excuse me, I didn't mean to interrupt your... The inn's full, ain't got no more rooms. Hey, boss, this guy looks like a real troublemaker. What do you want me to do with him? Rub him out. And everything goes black. Struggle as he might, Graham cannot escape his bonds. Now, this would be an unwinnable situation, and the game would kill you if you hadn't freed the mouse, and you only get one attempt at that. I told you I would repay your kindness when you saved me from that horrible rat cat. Good luck, friend. Okay, we need the rope, though. Graham stoops down and picks up the sturdy rope from the stone floor. And I don't remember... Oh, well, I may as well save, because I don't remember how dangerous it is going out. A rusty padlock on the door keeps Graham locked in. That's fine. That's why we bought the hammer. Knock, knock. Using the cobbler's hammer, Graham pounds on the rusty padlock until it breaks apart. Okay. And now, in theory, we should be able to open up and go. The only thing of value or use in the inn is in here. Graham looks around the kitchen and finds it rather sparse and untidy. Oh wait, no. It's in there. Inside the cupboard, Graham sees a large juicy leg of lamb. Remember the lamb from King's Quest 2? Reaching into the open cupboard, Graham pulls out the savory leg of lamb. Okay, let's take a look at the savory leg of lamb. This is a large mouth-watering leg of lamb. And we need to leave out the door. I think it's this door. Oh, maybe not. Hey, how did you get out of the cellar? Oh, I can't believe I did that. Okay. Let's try that again, shall we? As I say, you know, you don't have the mouse now. So, the second time around, so there's no way for you to get out of there. Okay, let's get this, and then not go that way. Inside the cupboard, Graham sees a large, juicy ham, and he takes it. And we look at it just to make sure that it doesn't give a score. I don't think it does. But let's be careful, and we're going to save. Not that I think I'm going to make the same mistake again, but... We'll go out this way. Graham unlocks the kitchen door before going outside. Right. And now, I believe, but I'm not sure, we're just going to save just to be safe rather than sorry. Anytime you really desperately want to go back in there, you can always do it through the back entrance. But we're not going to do that. Right. That is episode 4 all wrapped up. There's my timer. It was about to go. Thank you so much for watching. I've been Lostwolfe. This has been episode 4 of King's Quest 5. I will see you next week when we continue our journey with King Graham. I hope you have a great week, folks. I'll see you soon. Goodbye. This is getting tedious, Graham. Can we go now? Yes, we can. Goodbye.